tonight's concert is a special event for this ensemble, and is a little bit of a unique event that I want to give you a little bit of background about, because for the first time in over 20 years, our symphonic wind ensemble will be representing East Carolina University in Winston-Salem at the North Carolina Music Educators Convention. That concert happens at 1 o'clock on Monday. And so what tonight is for is a dress rehearsal, literal dress rehearsal of hopefully exactly, without being 1 o'clock in the afternoon, of exactly how that concert will feel, not only for the conductors, but especially for the performers. So tonight, there won't be a whole lot of talking between pieces. There'll be a little bit of talking. Dr. Staub will have a little bit of introduction at the very end and thank some people and things like that. But we're trying to make tonight as much like Monday afternoon as possible. The band will board buses on Sunday afternoon and on Sunday morning and travel to Winston-Salem and be there all day Monday for a dress rehearsal, for a sound check, and then their performance at 1 o'clock. So, but not only is tonight special because of the event that they're preparing for, and the people that they're going to be playing it for, but also the program that you're gonna hear. Tonight is a really special program because it features, every piece is by a diverse composer. There's a world premiere. The first piece is a world premiere. The concerto is a world premiere, and the first piece is a North Carolina premiere. And so the program that has been chosen has been chosen specifically for the audience of, honestly, it will be about 500 band directors from all over the state of North Carolina at their concert on Monday. So thank you for being here, and I now present the East Carolina University Symphonic Wind Ensemble under the direction of Dr. William Staub.
Thank you. the stage my good friend and colleague, Dr. Douglas Moore-Monroe.
Thank you.
Normally I talk a lot more in a concert than I have today, and it's just because we're practicing. At this point in time in the conference, there'll be somebody talking and presenting us a plaque. One of our students will go up and receive it, and they'll give me a little pin for coming and conducting at the NCMEA. All of that's wonderful and nice, but it's also good to practice this moment of repose during this program for the students, just to know what it feels like to go from one thing to the next. It's also good for me to feel that too, to be honest with you. Since I'm talking and it's not somebody else talking, I'm going to take the opportunity to thank some people. I took some notes, so bear with me. I'm sorry that I have to bring notes, but I brought some notes of people I want to thank. The first group of people I want to thank are Chris Olfers, Doug Moore-Monroe, Linda Keene, and all of the administration here at ECU for supporting us going to NCMEA. To do a trip like this costs thousands of dollars just because of transportation, lodging, food, registration, any number of things, printing the programs. All of those things cost money, and the administration supporting us is a really big deal, and I appreciate that, and the students appreciate that. The next group of people I want to thank are the applied faculty. They know I've been leaning on them a lot to give me their ears, to give me their input, and to tell me what they hear in our preparation for this concert. This is one of our biggest concerts that we've had in my time here at ECU. So getting great colleagues who have great ears, better ears than you do, to come in and listen to your group, I think it's a really important asset. And hopefully I'm modeling that for my students. Ask for help from people that are better than you. It's a good rule of thumb. So thank you to all the applied faculty that have been coming and helping. I really want to thank my good friend and colleague Joe Busuito for sharing the stage with me. It's always fun to be able to bring in a guest conductor. I always feel like we get better by watching somebody else get up there instead of me. And I'm sure they're tired of hearing me talk, so they're grateful to have somebody else get up there and talk. So I really appreciate Joe bringing his musicianship, his perspective, and his ears to rehearsal. He's been invaluable. I also want to thank Douglas Moore-Monroe. He and I arrived at ECU at the same time, when we got the invite, he was absolutely the person I wanted to ask to perform with us. And he has helped spearhead the commission of the harbor, that beautiful new concerto. Isn't that piece lovely? It's just gorgeous, gorgeous. Any band records that are in the audience, or any band records watching it on YouTube, that piece is still up for commission. You can contact me. It's a cheap entry fee, and it's under exclusivity rights for a year. So I highly recommend it. It's a beautiful piece. Amanda hopefully will be writing a lot more for band here in the future. Finally, the group I want to thank is the students on stage. You can probably ask them, and they will tell you that I've been kicking their behind. rehearsals to get ready for this, and they have just stepped up every time. Every single time they've stepped up. And they've gotten better, and they've gotten better, and they've asked, what else can we do? And they've done it. And that's an incredible luxury for me as a teacher, as a conductor, to have that with my students. And I'm just incredibly proud of them. So how about another hand for the students?
Thank you.